I mean, I've been there before. I know how it feels to have no motivation. And it's easy to give in and quit. The grind is hard. What's good? Yo boy Doc back again. I think you guys are really gonna love this series that I'm starting because I'm going back to my original roots, because I want to inspire everybody just by recording my grind and my work. So I started meeting up and inviting my subscribers to my workouts for free, of course, because I love giving back. And so this journey will just be some inspiration for those out there who feel like they're on the grind alone or just need help staying motivated. I mean, I've been there before. I know how it feels to have no motivation, and it's easy to give in and quit, which is why a lot of people are not successful, because successful is inconvenient. And let's be real, success is also not comfortable. The grind is hard. I'll show you guys and talk to you guys throughout this series about my struggles and what I had to overcome to get to where I am today. And just remember, behind every successful man and woman, there's a struggle. You can only be successful through the grind. So let's get it. Before we get the video started, I gotta do my shout out. So I got the shout out winner ready. And for today's video, the shout out goes to my homie Malachi Lamar. You're the winner for this video. He said, "Squad, Doc, you do so many great things. Thank you, bro. Keep working." So if you're new and you want to win a shout out, all you gotta do is join our family. Join the squad. There's only two steps. Just turn the bell on below this video next to the subscribe button right there, and then comment squad. I mean, why wouldn't you want to be a part of the squad? We're growing every day. Also, part three. So I'll let you guys know and keep you guys updated on part three. If you guys don't know, these burglars, they broke into my brother's car, stole all our presents, ruined Christmas for my little brothers. If you guys wanna go see the videos where we caught them, we set up a fake meetup and we caught them, and then we chased them to their house. If you guys wanna see that series, go check it out. It was my last video. And if you guys check my most recent videos, you'll see the other videos too. So go check those out. And also make sure you guys are following me on all my social media, because I do follow sprees, giveaways, and talk to all my fans through them. So it's lit. But I know y'all been waiting, so I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay tuned to the end, because I am gonna answer your guys' questions. Peace.
All right, good morning, your beautiful faces. My name is John, or the Narwhal, and I'm about to head out to go to Tacoma, which is like an hour away, to meet up with Ramel Dockery and put together a really cool weight room edit. And then the next day we're gonna do like a field edit. I don't really know what you call that, because I don't play sports, my bad. But yeah, so I'm gonna head out there. I don't really know where I'm driving, because he hasn't sent me his address yet and he's not up yet. So I'm just gonna head out towards that general direction and hope that he messages me. But yeah, it should be a pretty fun day and a pretty cool edit.
What's the plan today?
What's good? So today we're gonna try to get a workout in the weight room. And then after that, I think we might hit the field. Might hit the stairs, we don't know yet, but right now we're planning on hitting the weight room first and getting a lift in. So we're waiting to meet up with a couple other people, my little brother, and maybe Michael Rector, and we'll see what Cepho's doing. But yeah, that's the plan for today. It's gonna be a banger, so stay tuned.
All right, well, we're about to leave.
Where are you guys?
At Arby's. We're about to head to the Y. That's what we're doing. I told you to be here, Jamie. Not, so we're leaving.
All right, where are we heading to first?
We're about to go grab something to eat.
All right.
And we're about to, but it's gonna be light. And then we're gonna head to the gym to work out.
When you put the work in, man, it shows. Straight up out the ashes and I rose. Man, I done hit an all-time low. Been at a standstill and had to go, go, go. Man, they out here on a scheme like la, 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 la. Breaking promises you need like na, 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 na. No hearts, no love, no kumbaya, yeah. No hearts, no love, no kumbaya, yeah.
So, we made it in here, but I'm not really supposed to be filming, so I'm just pretending to stretch while Dockery's actually working out.
Hey, check out the mat.
I'm just sitting on this thing, like, literally not doing anything. Alright, so what's first?
Alright, so right now we're about to do some light squatting. Don't want to go heavy, because right after squatting, we're going to do lunges with the dumbbells. So, a little light squat, three sets of each.
You just rep your block. I'ma put my block on. We gon' make a move. Gon' get your popcorn. Riding with the tool. Fuck around, get shot. Dugging with my foolies. One time for my hoolies. Shout out to my hoolies. My young niggas on the road.
So Dockery's taking a quick break, but I have to be super secretive about filming because we're not allowed to film here and there's a dude walking around looking for people, so yeah.
All right, how'd the workout go?
The workout went good. We just finished up. Now I'm doing a little cool down on the bike. I usually always do this after a good workout. So right now, after I'm done cooling down, we're about to head to the stadium. We're gonna get a stair workout in and some field workout in. We might run some routes. We're meeting up with a quarterback, so it's gonna be pretty dope. But motivation tip of the day, or some motivation for today, because I always gotta motivate my subscribers. That's what the purpose of this video is, to inspire as many people as I can. And so a lot of times, you know, when we're depressed or down or negative, feeling negative, the motivation and tip that I wanna give you guys is just always fill your days with any type of positive energy as you can. Always wake up with a positive attitude, because a lot of times when we're depressed or down, or even when we're not doing anything, if we don't fill ourselves with that positive energy or positive thoughts, then something else has to fill that space. And a lot of times we get negative and it just takes over. And negativity, it's like a virus, man. So I always encourage my subscribers to stay positive, because if not, like I said, something else has to fill that space. So my brother's car actually got broken into. Some of you guys saw that on my story. And they just stole everything, over $1,000 worth of presents and stuff. And as soon as it happened, you know, we started looking for something good in that situation. Nothing bad. We weren't upset. We knew something good was gonna come out of a negative. And like I tell all you guys, look for the good in everything. Look for a positive in all negatives. And so that's just what I want to tell you guys out there who are going through something, feeling down, depressed. Look for a positive in every negative. So with that being said, we don't care about those presents or any of that got stolen. Maybe they needed it more than us, but we're staying focused on what God has planned for us. So we're about to go grind, get on this field. Got my little brother, he's about to meet up with us when we get to the field.
Hey, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. I got a lot more coming soon. We've already been recording, so hey, let me know in the comments if you guys loved it or want to see more, because we got some more for you guys. So just let me know if you guys enjoyed it. But like I do every video, I gotta answer some questions that you guys commented on the last video. The first question goes to my homie The Lost Weapon. He said, "Hey, Doc Squad, what made you play football?" And this is a really good question, because you know, I never really thought about it, besides my parents making me play it. But the main reason why I stuck with football is because I saw it as a way out for my family. I saw it as a way to take care of my family, and I was really good at it. That was really the reason why I played football. The second question goes to my bro, Ronnie Dale Schmidt. He said, "Hey Doc, I was wondering, for camps over the summer, should I go to different colleges every year or go to the same ones?" So with this one, I would say, if you can, try to go to different ones just to get exposure from every area you can, or as many different places as you can. That's what I did. I went to different camps all over the summer, and you can go to different camps throughout the summer. You don't have to just go to one over the summer. You can go to multiple ones, and so I would suggest that, because usually they only last like a week long. So next question goes to Psychic Gaming. He says, "Squad, how does numbering work in football?" And this is a good question too, because I never knew how they work when I got to college. But basically the coach will let you put your name next to the number that you want, which is what we did at Oregon State. The coach let us put our name next to the number we wanted when it came down to number picking. But usually when you get there, if someone is older than you and they already have the number you want, then they're gonna keep it, because I mean, they're older than you, so there's nothing you can really do. Yeah, that's the questions for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Again, let me know if you guys enjoyed it, and stay tuned for the next one. I love you guys. It's your boy Doc. I'm out. Hey, also, man, I just want to say to all my people out there who won the giveaways, you guys know what happened. I've been dealing with some family issues with these thieves. So the other day we actually had another incident happen. Some people ran through our mailbox, took all my grandma's mail out that she was sending out to family members, and they trashed it. They ripped them up, took all the cards out, and they were looking for money. Luckily my grandma wasn't sending money, just cards. They threw them in the road, left them in the street. Our neighbor actually picked them up and brought them back to our house. And then last night, somebody actually tried to break into our garage. So I'm kind of going through something right now. Just know I'm gonna have your guys' stuff shipped out ASAP. And you guys know they're coming because I already signed them. And I already let everybody know that you guys won. Just stay tuned, be ready for them. They're coming, I promise. I love you guys. Thanks for the support. Everybody, I love you guys. Peace.